This hand is no bueno. We would like to mulligan. Ugh. I think I have to keep this on the draw. If we draw a forest, we're set. If we draw another land, we can at least draw a Spirit Dancer. Draw plains. Yeah, I think... I don't think there's a way to throw that deck on the mold of six. Like, I can't imagine too many five-card hands being better than this, so... Alright, that's a good one. I'm guessing we're gonna see a Kiln Fiend or something here. Might just Flame Slash our guy, which we're... Oh, he's a Heat Rape, but we'd be fine with that, too. Since we're not leveling him up. Let me bash. Get in for my one damage if I can. If he wants to Heat Ray it, so be it. Our deck seemed pretty evenly matched, surprisingly. Looks like this one's going to be a pretty close one on my ball to six. His mold to six was obviously very close, and game one was pretty close as well. If he doesn't draw the Trace Instinct, game's over for him. So it's a pretty interesting matchup. Does this Dormant Gobazoa? Feels like a Dormant Gobazoa. Yep. Alright, so... play this. Play Wildheart Invoker. I think that's the best line of play. McKinney Griffin's also fine there if you want to play him, but like if one of our guys are going to get three, I'd rather get in for four or three as opposed to two or three. I mean, either way, we're only getting with one guy, so. Alright, Flame Slash. Acceptable. Level this guy wants. Griffin it up. Look like he has much offense this game, so something like a Student of Warfare might just be good enough. Obviously, we're going to have to deal with Guard Gomasoa, which is difficult for our deck, but we did board in a Leaf Arrow, so that's good. I'm guessing he has Mnemonic Wall here. No, that'd be a snap play. I don't know. Maybe something like Explosive Revelation. That seems like a pretty simple play, too. You just target the Student of Warfare and kill it no matter what. Draw a card. Could go for an Aura of some sort here. Emrakul's Hatcher. Alright, that's interesting. So we're going to level this guy up. Once, bash with our duders. I could level this guy up two more times this turn and wait on my Core Spirit Dancer. Which means I'll have him up to 4/4 next turn, since Spirit Dancer doesn't do anything right now anyway. But if I draw an Aura, I guess I want to have this guy active, so go ahead and play him. Having this guy as a 4/4 double strike doesn't even matter much, since it's just going to get blocked by Guard Gomazoa. I need a Splash Drake Umbro right now. Wonder if he has a big fatty in his deck that we don't know of. He's just got nothing. Seems interesting. I'll level that guy up after combat, I suppose. Do the one fake pump and then see what happens. We have Gelatinous Genesis in my hand, so I'm definitely going to, or in our deck, so I'm definitely going to play a land here. He's unblock. I don't know why you wouldn't block here. Is he just planning on heat raying or something? No, it certainly has Heat Ray in his hand. See if he uses it here or not. Nope. If we could draw something like Emergence Gaze, that'd be a good draw right now. Gelatinous Genesis is another good one. Angel's fine. Leaf Arrow's good. That guy's acceptable. So this guy's still going to get blocked, so there's no reason to do it now. If he's going to Heat Ray, he'll probably want to Heat Ray in response to the level up. So I'm just going to attack with him and the McGriffin.